A very good day, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Pranil Sana Kumadeva. My matrix number is 10DDT20F1079.
My name is Arunda Sana Parmugam. My matrix number is 10DDT20F1067.
My name is Muhammad Nur Shamil Bekujalawi, and my matrix number is 10DDT20F1036.
The system that we will be presenting to y'all is Dinosaur Learning Application that is developed by us. The Dinosaur Learning Application is a fully functional desktop application built using Visual Studio Software and .NET technology. This application will be used by the teachers and students in the kindergarten. The goal of this project is to enhance the quality of learning for the students and teaching by the teachers respectively, while improving the efficiency and effectiveness of this method. This Dinosaur Learning Application will provide a better and effective way to help students to get the learning materials and information. It includes all forms of electronically supported learning and teaching. This involves both out-of-classroom and in-classroom learning experience via technology. Not only that, this application also enables teachers and students to access the application at any time.
So the problem statement, the teachers tend to focus in their teaching because of traditional learning method. This is because they think it's the best way to share their knowledge to their students. But in using this method, there are some students who cannot follow or understand their own lesson because the teacher cannot explain it further because of limitation of time. Lack of time leads the teachers to not having any chance to give extra time for those students who is in need. Moreover, the traditional learning method consumes a lot of expenses. One of the reasons of expenses is because the materials that need to be printed and given to the students. For example, the teachers have to print or buy materials related to dinosaurs, such as books, articles, notes, and any hard copy every month or year for the students to expand their knowledge in dinosaurs. Furthermore, there's lack of adequate articles and learning materials related to dinosaurs for the students in the kindergarten itself, as the teacher do not want to purchase dinosaur learning materials since it's
The objective of the project are, first, to provide an e-learning application which can be accessed by teachers and the students. Second, to enable teachers to provide any learning material efficiently. And the last objective, to increase the proportion of individual work in the learning process and make the information and study materials better available for the students. The scope for this project is developed to assist the teachers and students at Kindergarten Smart Reader Kids Taman Bagan Ajam. The user scope, first the teacher. This application will be used by kindergarten teachers to upload and provide the learning material related to the dinosaurs. For students, this application will be used by kindergarten students to learn and obtain knowledge from the material given by the teachers. Students are also able to play quiz games which are related to dinosaur. So for the system scope, this project is developed for Kindergarten Smart Reader Kids Taman Bagan Ajam. The software used for the development of this project is Visual Studio 2022, visualbasic.net, software language, and MySQL database.
Once the application is launched, it will show this together with a music. So now I will click enter. To stop music, click this. And to play music, click this. So now, when in classroom mode, this mode will be conducted in the classroom during the lecture with teachers and students. So that means it will be handled by the teacher. So when click teacher mode, which is only the teachers were allowed to use, which means the teacher will handle this application while the students will be in the classroom to see the output and what the teacher is teaching the day. So when the teacher click teachers mode, it will pop up a login form. So if the username and password is not entered, It will show username or password are invalid. So which means we have to create an account. So we have to click here to register. And in here we'll register name. So when you click show, it will show password. Okay. Now when you click register, it will say successful registered. So the account that we registered just now is in this database, in this table. So Amar123. So now we'll log in. This is because the Amar is not the correct value that registered. So we'll add 11. This is the correct one. Login successfully. After login, it will bring to here, where it's teacher's notes and open file dialog. So once the teacher click the teacher's notes, it will pop up this. So this page means that the teacher will be able to upload PDF file into the database, into the table, and then it will also save in their computer device. So that means it will save in one specific file, and anytime when they click view, it will open the file and we can view the contents in it. So now first we're going to browse, we're going to upload an PDF file into it, open and click upload. So the scan file uploaded successfully. Click OK. And as you can see, this is the file. And in database, it is saved at here. Now, when the teacher click view, it will open the specific file. So as you can see, just now we uploaded this and this was already inside. So when the teacher click open, it will show in here. That's all for upload PDF. So when the teacher click back to close it, in file dialog, once teacher open file dialog and click PDF file, so this one means that in the classroom, when the teacher wants to show a PDF file from their device, their computer or laptop, so they can just open here. Open and view. So yeah, they can open and view and they can read. So this is during the class lecture. So when I click back, it will go here. So video file means almost the same thing, which means when the teacher wants to show a video from their device, laptop or computer. So we're going to open video file. Okay, we click open. So yeah, you can view this video. And once we click back, close. And once we click close, it will close the current interface. So yeah, that's all for the classroom.
About other learning materials. So when we click other learning materials, we can see the picture, videos, and also e-articles. When we click pictures, we can choose either one, herbivore or carnivore. So herbivore is a dinosaur that eat plants, and carnivore is dinosaur that eat only meat. So we just click herbivore, then we can choose such as Dracorax, Gastonia, and Minmi. So this is the example of the dinosaur. And if you click carnivore, we can choose the carnivore dinosaur, Allosaurus, Microraptor, and Spinosaurus. So this is an example of the carnivore dinosaur. Okay, when we click video, there is three video. So we can click on any of this video. So when we click video, we just click play video on top of this. So we can adjust the volume. Also can pause and also play and double click to full screen this video. The next is e-article. There are 6 e-articles, but this e-articles requires internet. So you can choose example dinosaur kids. So students can enjoy this web page about the dinosaur. That's all for other learning materials.
Okay, next is the game interface. Once we click game, it will appear for the game interface. So here we provided how to play the game for the children. So click on the flying dinosaurs before they fly up to the sky. So once we click game, so here we have speed, slow, normal, and fast. Student can choose. So now we choose normal and click new game. So once you click new game, student will able to play. Okay, once we click stop, here will appear click resume to continue playing or click new game to restart. Okay, we click resume to continue the game. Once we leave the dinosaur fly up, it will end the game and it will appear a message box. Game over. Here will show your score for the students. For the next is for the quiz. So once we click quiz, it will come out to the quiz interface. Here also we provided how to play quiz. Total of 6 questions. Each question is 5 marks. Read the question and answer it, then click next. Once all the questions answered, click submit. So at the score interface, we will show the green for correct answer and red for incorrect answer. Okay, play quiz. Okay, let's say if we click next without answering the question, it will appear a message box. Please choose an answer. Okay, once we answer the question, it'll go to the next question. Next. Okay, once done, click submit and it appears on. Okay, here for the score, for the green is a correct answer and the red one is the student answer is the incorrect answer. Here's a 15 marks. So 3 correct answer times 5 equals to 15 score. Okay, once all done, you click back, it will go to the main page.
How is the e-learning application? Do you all like it? How was the game? Was it nice?
Nice.
Okay.
In conclusion, the dinosaur learning application will play a vital role to enhance the quality of learning for the students and teaching by the teachers respectively at Kindergarten Smart Readers Taman Bagan Ajam. The main objective of this project is to help the students get over the traditional method of learning and make them acclimated to this application where the learning materials related to dinosaurs are easily available. It is inexpensive, efficient, and comfortable way for students to easily access their notes. The implementation of this project helps both students and teachers. Moreover, this project not only helps to facilitate easier access to notes for the students, but also helps in cutting down on expenditure for the kindergartens as well, where they spend a considerable amount of money on printing costs, which can be prevented. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.